On YouTube, Raider Squad here. This is gonna be a re-upload, but I deleted the other one because I had those old pair of Air Force Ones, and you couldn't really tell, like with good depth, how like the paint came on. It was just kind of like old and raggedy shoes. So today I went to Plato's Closet like 10 minutes ago and just picked up these Air Force Ones. You can see they're like basic. You can't really see because the lighting in my room sucks, but they're basically dead stock. It looks like they were worn a couple times, like maybe like 4 or 5 times, but they're in really good condition. So picked up those, so I'm gonna do that so you can see it on like the actual white shoe, and like I'm gonna treat it like it's brand new, so because it basically is. So anyways, I'm just gonna show you really quick what else I picked up. I got these at TJ Maxx, these joggers. They're like sweatpants joggers, and they're as you see here, hold on, sorry for the camera work. I'm holding it sideways in the front. It's Puma. So I picked those up. Those are like $20. And then I got this, I'm trying to do this with one hand, this tee right here. It's like baseball tee, LA on it. And then I got the same one. Not the same one, but like same like baseball tee type thing. But this one's black and white with the New York. So I got those for $10 each. And then my dad has some leftover jerseys sitting in his house, and he told me I could go over there today and see what he had. And then I ended up picking up these. These were the only ones of my size. I picked up this Orlando Magic, number 12. You know who that is. It's old-fashioned. Dwight Howard. Picked that up. I wear size 44. So, and then I got this one. This, some of you guys may not know who this is. It's, Indians. It's an Indians, number 99. Vaughn, you can't really see it, I got one hand. It's Ricky Vaughn off the movie Major League, Wild Thing, if you know who that is. But anyways guys, that's not part of the video. Guys who came here to see the paint sliders again, I guess. So yeah guys, I'm just gonna jump right in. Alright,
so obviously some of the supplies that you'll need is obviously your shoe, for starters. Whatever shoe you're doing, it doesn't have to be Air Force Ones. I know I'm just doing a video on it. You don't need it, but it's highly recommended. Is a X-Acto knife. It doesn't have to be an X-Acto knife. It just needs to be. It can be like a knife, just something sharp to get into like the edges. But I recommend an X-Acto knife because you can get like into the creases and stuff with it, and it's like easily accessible and like a knife. Obviously tape. To tape off the areas that you don't want, make sure you have a lot of it. And I forgot to mention in my last video, don't be afraid to overlap. Like if you have tape right here, don't be afraid to just like put another one right there next to it. It's like you almost want to overlap, so don't be afraid to have overlapping tape, because it's better to have overlapping than gaps in between, because then you're just gonna have to add more anyway. And second, don't be afraid to go on where you're painting. Like you can just tape over like the whole swoosh if you want, because that's what I'm doing. That's just all what I'm doing is the swoosh. But you could tape over the whole swoosh and then get your X-Acto knife or your knife, whatever you got, and then just cut it all out. So, like I said, don't be afraid to use tape. Use the tape. It's there for you. You don't be afraid to use it. So anyways, I'm gonna get tape into this shoe, but like in my last video, in the end it's gonna look like this if you're just doing a swoosh. Both sides, I got it. I'll show you in the end, like when I'm done taping this one, how to like put the stuff on it, like your saran wrap or whatever you're gonna use. So like I said in my last video, you just wanna get a good amount and then just start. You just want to put it on a good starting point and get right on it. So you see right there, no white space at all. So I'm not going to keep taping. You guys can see that, but I'll catch up with you guys once I get done taping this whole shoe, and I'll show you how to do the wrapping of the upper.
So, all right, guys. So now once you have everything taped, you just want to get it. And I'm just going to use some tin foil here. So you get your tin foil and you just go. Oh, what the fuck that was? Tape. Anyway, sorry about that. Get your shoe. Let me get the good side. Get your tin foil. Grab it and just cover the toe box like that. And then I gotta do it. Watch out, dog. Do it and you just wrap it around the shoe
on the bottom, just like that. Make sure everything's really tight around it. And just press it against the bottom. And then once you do that and you press it around everywhere, press it around all the sides so you can see everything. And so once you get that, it should look like this. So it should be real kind of tight around there. You just want to do that so you don't have to tape all on the toe box. So just do that, and I'm going to show you guys what to do next.
Once you get everything all taped up and everything, you just want to give your shirt kind of shake.
Alright, take it up. Make sure it's working. Alright. Key to this is you don't want to press too hard. You just want to lightly press it. Watch. Let's go. Go like this. You lightly press it down like this, and you'll see it spit out. You can hear it if you can't hear it. So, yeah. Show you a first person view of it. So that's how you want it to go. That's what I'm about to do it right now, and I'll let you guys see. Watch over your shoulders and keep a tin of beans for when the weather turn the coldest. The Lord is our shepherd, so our cup runneth over. Put your trust in the Lord, but tether your Chevy Nova. I'm spitting this shit for closure, and God is my witness, so you can get it for over. To all you magicians, right there. So I'm gonna finish these up, guys, and then I'll show you the results.
Alright, guys, so I got the finished product here. I forgot to mention in my last video of my how to do the spray paint or the paint speckles on the shoes, what type of paint. I feel like some of my people might ask and stuff. So what I use is, it doesn't have to be like this exact thing, but I recommend Valspar, because that's the only one with a type of top like this that I've seen. So yeah, anyways, that's what I recommend for if you're gonna use it. So anyways, onto the shoes. They turned out really good, and there's no paint marks at all. So yeah, I'm just gonna get right into them, guys. Just did it on the swoosh right there, as you can see. And these look like brand new. I mean, there's a couple marks like right there you can see, but that's gonna be cleaned so easily with the water and a rag. Literally, that's like nothing big. That's like just a little dirt. So these are basically DS. See here, same side. But yeah, I think it's just a real simple, but like it gives it more character, I think. I mean, I love the all white. I love the detail of it, but it's just like, I just felt like I had some black paint speckles. So I'm just gonna put up a couple detailed pictures of them, and hope you guys enjoy the video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, guys. So it's been Raider Squad, and I'm out.
Lights out, take your shirt off, my phone ringing, bustin' word.